who you are, and go from there. A little about yourself.
What's up, y'all? My name is Kilo Too. Obviously, I'm a product of an urban gangster. And, you know, most of the stuff that I went through, going through killing, growing up in the hood, a lot of stuff that I went through, you know, coming in contact with a lot of cats, and it's like really impacted my life. And so, basically, man, it's like, you know, you look at the way the game is now, man, everybody is an urban gangster in their own way. We have all these different cultures. We have, you know, you have the whites, you have the essays. Everybody's emulating in this one culture, so it was sort of like spreading like wildfire. And so basically, man, pretty much everybody's an urban gangster in their own way.
So what's an urban gangster?
It derives from the actual gangsters, you know, the shoot 'em up, bang bang, drive-bys, and everything that's associated with it. Eventually, with the hip-hop culture and all the other things that came along with that, you know, it began to sort of take on its own form. It depends on which culture was affected by it. You know, you have the white, you know, they're urban gangsters in a different kind of way with the skateboards and doing the tag and all that. And you have the Hispanics that's urban gangsters in their own right because, you know, they have the low-lows and, you know, basically the stuff that we're doing, you know, because the essays and the black group are really kind of synonymous in a lot of ways, but then they're different in a lot of ways in regards to, you know, their order and how they fit together and stuff like that. So,
How come the gangster appeals to so many people because it's a positive thing to see.
That's what you see. You see it on TV, you see it on your videos, you see it, you know, you see the big homies on the corner doing their thing. You want that, you know, regardless of what's being taught in your household, man. When you leave your household and you see all the things going on, everybody wants to be popular. I haven't met one person that wants to be unpopular. Or doesn't want to be in the in crowd. If you're a nerd on the chess club, you're going to be a nerd on the chess club because they can't be in the crowd. Urban gangsters influence fast in a lot of ways. And, you know, I can speak personally. Urban gangsters influence fast in regards to, you know, we didn't have money to buy the, you know, the Jordan Ashes and the Tommy Hills and all that stuff, you know, that stuff that came along with, you know, with quote-unquote fashion. And so basically what we did was we took something that was cheap, like khakis and t-shirts and house shoes, and we made it trendy. And so now, you know, and what everybody, you know, turned their nose up and scoffed at us, now, you know, you got everybody wearing t-shirts and khakis. You know what I mean? You have blacks, whites, Latinos, Asians. I seen a white boy the other day, you know, trash. So it's a culture type thing, you know. So I think it transcends, this culture transcends race, religion, and everything else, man. It is exactly what it is, the culture. And it's direct fashion. Now you have all these companies, these clothing lines coming out with baggy jeans, you know, even the skater line is coming out with baggy jeans and everything that fits that facade, you know, and it's a facade because it's not even real. You know, you make stuff that you say, well, I like that, and so I'm going to roll with that, but really, if you can afford something different, like, wait,
being an urban gangster, how do you feel about that when you see it?
Personally, how I feel when I see a urban kid, a rich kid in an urban gangster, I sort of have mixed feelings about that because, number one, I'm looking at it in perspective that, you know, I came from a long line of real gangsters, and this is what we really did, and we did it, we didn't do it, you know, because we wanted to, it was out of necessity. We did this thing because we had to. And we, you know, we dressed and we did that way because we couldn't afford that now. And we, you know, and this is what was our environment was all about. And then when I sort of see, you know, rich kids that really don't have to do it that way, I'm sort of pissed in a way because I know where that life leads to eventually. And they can avoid a whole lot of stuff that, you know, that I couldn't afford it. But, and then in a way, I feel that, you know, they got a right to be who they want to be. So, you know,
which is the main difference between a hardcore urban gangster and a regular urban gangster, the average Joe if you walk down the street.
The difference between an average urban gangster and a hardcore urban gangster. That's pretty self-explanatory right there. The difference is in the mindset, the attitude. The difference is in just in being. The difference is when every time you take a breath, you know you and Jesus, you ride, you have to live and die for your hood. And you are an urban gangster, for real. You are in an urban environment, and you are a real gangster. And the difference between that, you know, you got is the
opposite. And what I think of the styles of gangsters, and like the Chinese, or the Asian gangs, from China, I'm talking about the triads, and like the mafia didn't take off the way urban gangsters took off.
In terms of the popularity. I think the popularity of urban gangsters is a lot different from the mafia and other, you know, sects in a lot of ways, because, you know, you have the mafia and other, you know, organizations to where they sort of segregate themselves from everybody else. The urban gangster thing is universal. And everybody can claim a piece of it for itself. And so it's not something that you can even contain. See, the mafia can contain, you know, their organization in regards to how they operate and everything else. But a culture, you can't contain a culture. It's going to be what it is, and it's going to grow in its own way. And so everybody takes a piece of it for themselves. But there's no way you can control that. So that's what the popularity of it is that you can take a piece of it and make it your own without actually having to be like it.
Thank you.